The story is a familiar one, but there is so much more to consider. Many imagine that the world into which Jesus came was not complicated, not full of problems, fear, or greed. But historians tell us otherwise. Jesus came at a time when a deeply disturbed world had grown hopeless and was in need of a savior. Mary and Joseph had been ordered to fulfill their civic duty and travel to the town of their birth to register for the Roman census. The Roman emperor, Caesar Augustus, had ordered the census not so much to count the population, but more to determine how much gold the Roman people would owe him in taxes. All over the Roman world, people would return to their hometown, where their family first lived, to be counted there. This was not easy or convenient. Mary, who was no more than a teenager, was expecting her firstborn son, a son who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and who was to be born the Son of the Most High. The journey for our young couple from Nazareth in Galilee to Bethlehem in Judea was some 100 miles on a long and difficult road. They would spend 4 days and nights traveling this tremendous distance by donkey or walking and sleeping along the side of the dangerous and crowded road. And yet, they knew in their hearts that there was more to this journey than honoring the authority of government. They knew that God's marvelous plan to save a dying world called them to travel to the city of David to fulfill the prophecies foretold thousands of years ago. Mary and Joseph arrived in Bethlehem to the hustle and bustle of a busy town. And while there was room for merchants, tax collectors, travelers, and sightseers, there was no room for them in the inn. No room for the Son of God. The best the innkeeper could do was to offer the couple the stable where the animals were kept. And all of this came to be, for God had chosen the town of Bethlehem to cradle his son.
Livestock. But what a blessed and holy birth it was. Mary had found favor with God and trusted his plan for her life, and she was blessed, and blessed was the child she bore. For this child was the long-awaited Messiah who would rule over our hearts, not nations. This child was a God clothed in human form who chose to dwell among us so he could fully be one of us.
Took on a new brilliance, and the angels sung a grand anthem. Glory in excelsis Deo, glory to God in the highest. The guiding star would also lead the Magi from the distant lands to find the child. These stars would shine through the ages to say to all that this starry night would conquer all darkness and bring forth the light of the world.
Each of us, like Mary, when we seek him and long to please him. Through the ages, this God who dearly loves us offers the same invitation as he delivered to the shepherds long ago. Come to the manger. Seek him again in your heart, for he loves you and desires for you to renew your faith and your hope and return to your normal lives as a changed people.
Thank you. that your baby boy is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day
Your Everlasting Father, your Prince of Peace, your King has come.